Dear learners of Standard 7, it's a very good morning and welcome back to my today's Science Geography class. Hopefully, you all are fine, safe and sound at your home by the blessings of Almighty Allah. Already, you have known about the Earth's diurnal motion or the rotation on its own axis. Another motion of the Earth is annual motion. So, today I am going to teach you that annual motion of the Earth. The Earth takes 365 days and 6 hours to move around the Sun in its own orbit. The period of the Earth takes to complete the revolve or revolution is known as the solar year or simply year. So, we are going to learn today the annual motion of the Earth. We know the definition of the annual motion, that is, the Earth takes 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes and 47 seconds to move around the Sun in its orbit. So this motion of Earth is known as annual motion. And here you are observing the Earth is rotating from west to east, that means Earth is spinning on its own axis, and effect of this motion is the day and night occurs. That is, for this motion, diurnal motion, for the diurnal motion, Earth's day and night occurs. And Earth is also revolving around the Sun in its own elliptical orbit. So this motion is known as annual motion, and Earth takes once to complete this motion is 365 days and 6 hours. So now follow the Earth having a full rotation on her own axis for 24 hours and simultaneously moves around the Sun on a set route on an elliptical orbit, that is, orbit once in a year. This is known as solar year or simply year. This movement of the Earth is known as the annual motion. And for this annual motion, the Earth takes 365 days and 6 hours to move around the Sun in her orbit. So the period the Earth takes to complete the revolution is known as the solar year. Now, effects of annual motion. Major two types of effect occur due to annual motion. One is increase or decrease of length of day and night, that means fluctuation of day and night length, and the change of seasons occur as a result of annual motion. Do you see the same weather throughout the whole year? If I ask you the question that do you see the same weather throughout the whole year? In the month of January, or if I tell you in Bengali, that is the Bengali month, Poush and Magh, is it hot or cold? And is the weather of Ashar and Shravan same like the winter time, that is Poush and Magh? No, it is quite different. In Bangladesh, we see different weather in different time. We feel cold in the month of January and hotter in the month of Bengali month, that is May, June, or the Bengali Boishak Joshto. Can you say why? You will be able to answer when you would know about how the Earth moves around the Sun. So these types of how the season change occur and what happened when the increase or decrease of length of day and night occur, this if we want to know the answer of these types of questions, we must have to know the annual motion of the Earth. So here written about the four conditions of the Earth. In this figure, you are observing the four conditions of the Earth. This is the 21st June. What will be the condition of the Earth? And this is 23rd September. This one is 22nd December, and this one is 21st March. So each and every condition of the earth takes 3 months. So here 4 conditions. So given the 3 4 12, so 12 months, that means at least 1 year. So to revolve around the sun, earth takes 365 days and 6 hours. So we will start from 21st June. Here one thing you know, but another time I want to make you clear, that is this portion is the equator, and this equator divides the earth into 2 equal halves, that is from the equator up to north pole it is the northern hemisphere, from the equator up to south pole it's the southern hemisphere. And in the northern hemisphere, 2 major important lines, that is Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle, which are situated in the northern hemisphere. And another 2 major lines, that is the Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. This is the Arctic Circle and this one is the Antarctic Circle. So which are situated in the southern hemisphere. So here these 5 major lines you must have to remember. And we live in the which hemisphere? Northern hemisphere. And our Bangladesh situated in the northern hemisphere. And major part is Tropic of Cancer passes through Bangladesh. So this Tropic of Cancer passes through Bangladesh. So in northern hemisphere, eastern part, here is the position of our country. And this is the vertical position, and earth is rotating on its own axis in a elliptical way. So the angular part is 23.5 degrees. So earth takes the angle which is 23.5 degrees, and making this angle, earth is rotating on its own axis. So this is here one time given, so you will practice this figure also by denoting this part in any one condition of the earth. So today I will discuss what will happen just on the 21st June and the day of 22nd December. So beforehand I have told you we live in the northern hemisphere, and Bangladesh comes closer to the sun on the 21st June. So as we live in the northern hemisphere, and I told you Tropic of Cancer passes through Bangladesh, so Bangladesh get the vertical or perpendicular heat on Tropic of Cancer on 21st June. So at that time we find the sun above our head. So on 21st June is the longest day and shortest night in the northern hemisphere. So dear learners, the earth rotates around the sun, being little bit inclined towards the sun, we know. And but the earth changes its inclined position at different time of the year. So a particular part of the earth faces the sun at a particular time. A definite part of the earth facing the sun gets sun heat vertically for a long time. In that part of the earth, the summer prevails. So, on 21st June, summer prevails in the northern hemisphere. So, you have already known that the equator of the earth is divided into two. Northern part is called the northern hemisphere, southern part is called southern hemisphere. And we live in the northern hemisphere. So the sun reaches its northernmost limit on 21st June, and the date is known as summer solstice. So solstice means what? I will tell you. Sol means sun and stis means stand still. But during this time there has been downpouring due to monsoon wind in Ashar and Shravan. So after summer comes the winter season. So what we have learned from here? on the day of 21st June, Sun gives the perpendicular heat on the Tropic of Cancer of the Northern Hemisphere, and here the longest night and longest day and shortest night. Okay, but on the day of 21st June, what happened in the Southern Hemisphere? Southern Hemisphere, here occurs as the Sun not gives perpendicular heat on the Southern Hemisphere, so here only occur the longest night and shortest day. Then the heat of the Sun becomes inclined, at the heat of the Sun is inclined at an angle. As a result, the Southern Hemisphere at this time gets less heat of the Sun, and when there is winter comes, such as in Australia, and Australia is situated in this position, carry the Tropic of Capricorn. So the Australia is situated in the Southern Hemisphere and Bangladesh is situated in the Northern Hemisphere. So on the day of 21st June, this is summer season, and in Australia, which is situated in the Northern Hemisphere, there is the winter season. Now solstice, summer solstice. Here follow the summer solstice, also known as estival solstice or midsummer. I told you that is sol means sun and stice means stand still. So the summer, in summer solstice time, the Sun gives the perpendicular heat for 24 hours from the line latitudes, that is Arctic Circle in Northern Hemisphere, 66.5 degree up to 90 degree north. And here the summer solstice, also known as estival solstice or midsummer, this is occurs when one of the Earth's poles has its maximum tilt towards the Sun, and it happens when twice yearly, once is in each hemisphere. So it happens twice yearly, one is summer solstice, another is winter solstice. For that hemisphere, the summer solstice is when the Sun reaches its highest position in the sky and is the day with the longest period of daytime within the Arctic Circle to Antarctic Circle, that is continuous daylight around the summer solstice. So for one day, 24 hours, the Sun gives the heat, perpendicular, oblique or more oblique heat, but the people of these countries enjoy 24 hours daytime. Then the winter solstice, same thing will happen, just here Sun gives the perpendicular heat on Arctic Circle and here just Antarctic Circle. So follow the winter solstice, hemal solstice or hibernal solstice occurs when one of the Earth poles has tilts maximum tilt away from the Sun, that is the southern pole, and it happens twice yearly, once in each hemisphere, you know that northern or southern. For that hemisphere, the winter solstice is the day and the shortest period of daylight and the longest night of the year, when the Sun is at its lowest daily maximum elevation of the Sun. So here the winter solstice, at the winter solstice time, Sun gives the perpendicular heat on Antarctic Circle. So from the Antarctic Circle up to Southern Hemisphere, here the 24 hours it will be night time. So dear learners, today up to this, you will learn the next day, 22nd December, the consequence of day and night and season change occurs. So the effect of annual motion of 22nd December. Thank you all.